crackling sound.
This is kind of a fuzz tone, emphasizes that, gives it a dramatic entrance to just give it a bit of oomph, you know, slightly out of time and everything. I'll play you a section of the song, tweaked a few levels. I was in the desert dreaming
sand. Hi, welcome to part two. This is the recording of my song Jackdaw Alien and the whole process from start to finish. Last week we covered a click track, drums, getting the bass down, doing scratch tracks and of vocals and acoustic guitar, and also recording the acoustic guitar proper. Today we're going to record the electric guitars, and if we have time, the piano as well. So without further ado, let's dive in. Right, I'm using an amp, this Fender Mustang here. I've got a microphone set up so I can record the sound from the speakers, which I like the sound of. Gives me an extra option. I'm using a wide diaphragm condenser mic because I don't want to have the amp too loud. So the wide diaphragm condenser is more sensitive, so it'll pick up a quieter signal. I've got some effects. I've got a tuner and a fuzz tone effect, the brown acid thing. And I've also got a line out going into my audio interface. Here, the second input, there's the mic input, there's the line out, which is a balanced cable, TRS balanced, which helps to reduce any interference along the cable. Now what I've decided to do, I've got my electric guitar here, and there are two distinct parts of the song. There's the introduction and the bridge, and I want a different sound on that than I want in the verses, so I'll record the different parts separately. So I'll record the intro and the bridge first in a kind of clean sound, and then I'll do a more distorted thing for the distorted rhythm guitar for the verses and the choruses. So that's where I'm going. So
just recording the bridge lead guitar. I've been recording the rhythm guitar, which is a kind of I'll try another rhythm guitar in the verses and choruses now, which is slightly cleaner, and this is kind of a fuzz tone. I'll do a cleaner, a bit crunchy, but a slightly cleaner rhythm guitar sound now, so I'll go for that. I think I found the setting on the amp for the extra rhythm guitar. It's a I think that's the sort of sound I'm after, so I'll just record that now. It's just thought I need to check on my tuning to make sure you're in tune when you're recording. It's very important. It can go out after one take, so just keep a check on it. So I just noticed that I was slightly out. And now after listening, I think the intro and the bridge rhythm side of it is possibly a little bit too clean. The guitars I put down are good, but I think I put another one with this same slightly distorted guitar on the intro and the bridge. I like that a downbeat on the when the main riff comes in. This sort of emphasizes that, gives it a dramatic entrance to the main part of the verse riff. So that's where I'm going with that. I'll do the bridge part now. Right, I've recorded The verses and the choruses, and I've put a clean guitar on the bridge. I've recorded a lead guitar on the bridge and intro, and I thought I'd put a bit of a lead guitar on the ending as well after it comes out of the last chorus.
Right, so what I have now is, I think I've got all the guitars in place that I need for this song. What I'll do is I'll just comp them, arrange the best bits and make sure everything sounds okay and I've got everything I need before I move on. I plan on doing some piano on top of that to just emphasize the dun dun dun. As you can see, I've got my MIDI controller, my MIDI keyboard here ready on my desk. And I've got an app open. It's called The Gentleman. It's a thing in Native Instruments complete package. It goes. That's all I'm going to do with it, because I want to keep it simple. I'm not going to put the third of the chord in there, just basically the root and the fifth. And all it's for is to emphasize those beats, really, to just give it a bit of oomph. Right, I've done all the guitars. I put the piano in. What I did was I wrote a MIDI file for the piano using my MIDI controller and wrote a MIDI file. I quantized it to eighth notes so that it's on the beat, because it needs to be on the beat, the piano. It's all right for the guitars to be, you know, slightly out of time and everything, but the emphasis needs to be on the beat. So I've quantized it, and then I've rendered it to an audio file. So what we'll do now is I'll play you a section of the song. It's not a full mix, it's not a proper mix or anything, and the vocal still needs doing. As I say, it's just a guide vocal, a scratch vocal, this, so it is rough, and the whole thing's a bit rough as well, so there's no mixing going on particularly. It's just, you know, tweaked a few levels and added a little bit of reverb to make it sound a little bit sweeter. But yeah, have a listen to this second verse.
I was in the desert dreaming sand. I was there forever with time slipping through my hands. I never saw a soul around. I felt my body buried, my head poking out the ground. And every time the sun came up, I cursed the world for turning round and round. And every time came up, I cursed the world for turning round and round.
There we have it. There's the bit of the second verse and chorus, and a little tiny bit of the bridge as well, so into the bargain. But that's what we got so far. As I say, the vocals need doing, which I'll address next week. I'll have to warm my voice up and get limbered up and deliver a great vocal on this. I'm liking the way it's turning out. There will be some drum editing needed as well, so a few more fills and things perhaps, and make the drums a bit more interesting. They're very basic at the moment. So subscribe, hit the notification bell, do what you need to do, like the video, that's important, and keep watching. It's all a part of the process. I'm doing this to share my journey as a musician, and this song is an old one that's been close to me for a long time, and I feel like an alien myself, to be honest, sometimes. And I certainly did at the time when I wrote it. I was very much alienated from everything. So, yeah. I'll see you again next week. Bye for now.